label it or something. Yeah, what do I do with that?
Exit out.
I didn't want to do that last time.
For the concert. Semper Fidelis. That was on a mind blank whenever you're out in front of people. Those two songs are two of his more famous pieces. I picked this song specifically because it introduces a new concept for junior high 6/8. If you know anything about music, it's the first time for many of the kids where the quarter note does not equal one beat, and that's a little bit of a new concept. They did a very good job with it. The next song we're going to be playing is Wind River Overture. This was actually composed by a Minnesota native, Bruce Pearson. If you have ever looked at your students' standard of excellence books, you'll notice that Bruce Pearson was the person who wrote that series, and it's used all around the world. So we'll be playing Wind River Overture. Is the great locomotive chase. This is a very unique piece in that it not just a composer making up a melody to something, it's actually a composer trying to tell a story with that song. This is based off of a great locomotive chase that happened during the Civil War. Some Union soldiers hijacked a Confederate train and tried to destroy a lot of the tracks leading all the way up into the border between the North and the South to help break some of their supply lines. And what's happening in the song, we first start with the train first starting out, and then all of a sudden it gets to a very, very fast speed, and the train is going out of control. And then towards the end of the song, you hear the train actually slowing down. Our students are actually doing some different things that will make it sound very much like a train. Some of the flutes are doing different techniques with their instruments. You can actually hear some vocalization with some of the parts. So I hope you enjoy Great Locomotive Chase. After this song, we will do a quick little intermission before we have the high school band come up.
Thank you.
Our first song was Another March, this one by Henry Fillmore called His Honor. Now, the person who edited this version of Henry Fillmore's His Honor was a man named Frederick Fennell. He is known by most people as actually the father of the modern concert band. Before his time, most bands that were happening in universities and things were mostly brass bands, not very many woodwinds and things. He, and most of the music that was written was actually transcriptions from orchestral music, some of the older stuff. He started getting composers to write for specifically concert bands, and this is where it has evolved to. Our next piece is actually our contest piece that we'll be playing next week, our main contest piece. It's so American River Songs by a man named Pierre Laplante. It has three basic movements to it. There will be no stopping between them, so you don't have to worry about no one to clap. This piece uses a lot of American folk songs, specifically about rivers. We have a couple soloists in this one. We have a soloist, White Eason, and also Adam Martin.
Thank you.
saga. Now, if you're confused by me saying our main piece for contests, every school that goes to a large group contest needs to pick at least one song from a master list of different songs that are approved by the Minnesota State High School League. That was River Song's, that main song that fulfills that criteria. Our second song that we'll be playing will be Southwest Saga. This one has a very, very distinct western, southwest type of feel to it. And on this one, some of our different soloists will be Anna Bonstetter, Anna Mathewitz, and then Wyatt Keeson and Noah Luckies. Playing a little duet towards the middle of the song. Thank you so much for coming to our concert. Please stick around for the choir concert. I know it's going to be amazing, especially with the little trumpet at the end.
Yeah.
Drive safe.